Hi, we have seen what is Kirchhoff's law and Ohm's law in the last video. Now we are going to see some problems which is solved today using this Kirchhoff's law and Ohm's law. Till now we have seen I think 8 problems. This is the 9th problem. Look at the circuit. For the circuit in the figure, find the voltages V1 and V2. This is the circuit given to you. You have to find the voltages of V1 and V2. So to find the voltages, you have to use the Kirchhoff voltage law. Okay, assume that current I is flowing through this circuit. So it is mentioned here, I is flowing in the circuit. From Ohm's law, you can find out V1 is equal to 2 into I. Okay, this is plus, so symbol is plus. Here V2 is equal to minus 3 into I. So if you are applying KVL, you have to write the KVL using this. So this is minus 20 volt, this is plus V1, this is minus V2, which is equal to 0. Clear? Now you are going to substitute the V values into the equation. Minus 20, V1 is 2i, V2 is minus 3i, which is equal to 0. So just you are substituting this value, minus 20, V1 is 2i plus 3i. If you add this to, then 5i, which is equal to minus 20 taken to the right side, 5i equal to 20, then I equal to 4 ampere. You have find out the I, then you can just substitute this I value in the V1 and V2. You will be getting the voltages of V1 and V2. So you have got the values of V1 and V2 here. So very easiest problem. We can see to the, we are going to the problem number 2 in Kirchhoff's law and Ohm's law. Same like that, you have to find V1 and V2 in the circuit. Okay. So I have solved using the Kirchhoff's law. You can solve using the old method also, or you can take like this also. Like, instead of taking this negative value minus 10, I have taken plus 10. You can take it in any way. I have taken like this, which means drop. This is, I am taking, this is potential drop, this is potential rise. So I am taking potential drop to rise. So I am taking plus 10. Okay. So here I am taking minus 4. Then this is again potential drop to rise. I am taking, this is plus 8. Here I am taking minus 2i, okay, which is equal to 0. In this method, you have to take, okay, if you are taking like this, you can solve this problem as like the old problem also. You can just like taking the equation with the signature or with the sign, you can write what is V1 and what is V2 like this, then you can substitute like this. Or directly you can take like this. I have taken this value as potential rise, so I have taken positive. So rest of these resistors I am directly taking into negative with irrespective of signs. Only I am taking with the signs for the sources. So this is potential drop to rise, I am taking plus 10. Similarly here, this is, if you take the current flowing in clockwise, this is also drop to rise. I am taking it as positive. Rest of these two elements I am taking in just negative sign, which is equal to 0. Then you just simplify this. These two will be added and these two will be added. You will be getting I equal to 3A. Then you just take V1 is equal to plus 4 ohm. Here the V2 is equal to minus 2i. Here 4i, you just substitute this 2 value, then you will be getting this value. Instead of this, you can just write minus 10 plus V1 minus 8 minus V2 equal to 0. You can write it, then you can substitute this 2 value, then you will be getting the same equation. You can write in any way according to your wish. So you can do which method do you want. Here I have given in another way, that this is taken as positive, this also taken as positive, the rest of the two resistors have been taken as negative. Okay, or you can take like this method, like you can separately write what is V1, what is V2, then you can write like this. Okay, then you can substitute what is V1 and V2. You can, both the equations will be same. Okay, old method I am again giving you here. See here, I have written what is V1. V1 is plus 4i. Similarly, V2 is equal to minus 2i. Because we are taking in clockwise, in that it is taken as positive, it is taken as negative, because the current is coming and meeting with negative pole first. So V1, V2 we have written. So according to the KVL, we have written minus 10, okay, plus 4. Instead of 4, I have written plus V1. Then this is minus 8 minus V2 is equal to 0. Okay. Now V1 is 4i. You have to substitute this value. Then V2 is minus 2i. If you substitute this value, you will be getting this. You look this equation and this equation, both are same. Minus 10, instead of minus 10 I have written plus, then plus 4i, this is minus 4i, this is minus 8, this is plus 8, so here minus 2i, so this is plus 2i, so both are same only. So you can write as your wish, you can write like this or you can write like this, then you will be finding what is the value of I. And then you can find what is V1 and what is V2. Okay. Next problem. Determine V0 and I in the circuit shown in the figure. So this is the circuit. You have to find out what is V0 and what is the current. So just we are taking the current flowing in clockwise direction. So like last method I am writing. This is drop to rise, potential drop to rise. So I am taking plus 12 minus 4i. Then this is a source voltage, again this is potential rise to drop. If you will take like this, then you will be getting minus 2v0, because this is rise to drop. So I am taking negative, like here it is drop to rise, so positive. This is rise to drop, so I am taking, this is negative. Then this is also source, again this is drop to rise, so we have to take this as positive. Then this one we have to take it as negative. So in this method the resistors should be taken as just negative only. Then when you are writing the values of voltage, that time you have to take it in negative with sign. This is plus and minus we have to consider, so we are taking this is plus 4i, but we no need of this voltage here, we want to find this only. So I am taking V0, current is flowing in this direction, so V0 is equal to minus 6i. I am taking, just I am substituting this value here, then 12 minus 4i plus, instead of this value minus into minus plus, so 12i plus 4 minus 6i equal to 0. From this I am finding I value, then this I value I am substituting in V0, so I have find out what is V0. If you have confusion in writing directly like this, for you I am just writing as a first step. If you see here, so symbol is minus 12, then there is no symbol, so we have to take plus minus. So I am taking plus 4i, then plus 2v0, so then minus 4, then minus v0, which is equal to 0. Then you have to write the V0 value. V0 is equal to minus 6i. If you substitute this value here, then you will be getting minus 12 plus 4i plus 2V0 minus 4 plus 6i. Okay. I forget to substitute this minus 6i here. If I substitute this minus 6i here, okay, you will be getting 2 into 6, okay, 2 into 6 minus 2 V naught you will be getting. So this equation and this equation both are same. If you look, you can see here. So minus 12, instead of minus 12 you have plus, instead of minus here you have plus, here you have 12 I. If you look, substitute this value, you will be having minus 12 I. This is same. Then here plus 4, here minus 4, here plus 6, and there, so both are same only, which means if you multiply with either minus you will be getting this value, or if you will just rearrange it then you will be getting same equation. Either you can go with this method or you can go with this method. So you will be getting I value as minus 8, then if you will substitute this value then V naught will be 48. Next problem, you have to find out what is Vx and what is V naught. Same like that, you are going to take I current is flowing in the circuit. So I am taking 35 minus 10 I, then this is plus and minus, so I am taking minus 2 Vx, then minus 5 I is equal to 0. Next you have to write what is V naught and what is Vx. So Vx is equal to plus 10 I, V naught is equal to minus 5 I. Substitute this V naught value and Vx value here. So V naught is equal to minus 5 I, Vx is equal to 10 I. Just substitute this Vx value, then you will be getting the I value. Just substitute this I value and get the V naught value. So your Vx is 10 volt and V naught is 5 volt. So you have to find what is Vx and what is V. This is the circuit, same circuit when I was solving this, I have just drawn this. Just ignore this diagram. This is the final value. Same like first method, you can just try it and you will be getting the same answer. Then next problem is, you have to find out what is I naught and what is V naught. So if you want to find out what is I naught, then you have to go for the KCL. So consider this A is called a node. Then if you write the KCL for this, so here one current is incoming, this is outgoing, then again here this current is incoming, so this also a current source, this also a current source. To find out what is V naught, so you have to write what is V is equal to IR formula using Ohm's law. So V naught is equal to I naught into R. So you are writing KCL. I have told you 0.5 I naught is incoming current, 3 is also incoming, this is outgoing. So I have written 0.5 I naught plus 3 is equal to I naught outgoing. So if you rearrange this and solve this equation, you will be getting 6 ampere. So you have find out what is I naught. Then you have to find out what is V naught. V naught is equal to I naught into V naught. So I naught into V naught, sorry, I into R. V equal to I into R. So I naught into R, R is 4. So V naught is equal to I naught into 4. I naught is 6 ampere, then V naught is 24 volt.